Welcome back to my channel, you guys. I hope you're all doing okay. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create this foxy eye look. It's the new trend that has been going around. So I thought it's important for me to show you how to create this look. For those who are new here, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel. And now let's get started. So to begin with, I'm going to first fix my hair. And for that, I'm going to take a section of my hair right above my ear and pull it back. You will be able to see the difference drastically as your eyes and eyebrows would get lifted. Here is my before and after look. Now in my case, you will not be able to see any drastic difference, but I will still go ahead and do this step as eventually it will help me get that snatched and lifted look. Now I'm going to take the section of my hair from both the sides and just take the hair on top and secure it so that I can tie the two sections firmly underneath it. I've taken both the sections and I'm going to pull it backward as tight as I can, and I'm going to secure it with a tiny hair tie just so that it stays and it gives me that lifted look. You also have to ensure that you tie it extremely high and not low so that it gives you that lifted and angular look that you're looking for. Now for the brows, they have to be a little more lifted and straight, so I'm going to try avoiding the arch that I already have naturally. And first I'm going to start with the fiber gel from Benefit and comb my hair first and then define them properly. For my brows, I'm going to use the Benefit Brow Cream Gel Brow Color in the shade 5, and then I'm gonna just clean it up with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Pro Pencil. I'm also gonna be creating hair-like strokes rather than just filling it in like the usual way we always do. If you notice, I'm going to end right here and not go a little further like I always do, because I want it a little straighter, and if I stop here, I think it gives a little straighter and sharper look. Now I'm going to apply a little bit of foundation on my eyelid just to cancel out any discoloration and pigmentation I have so that I can get a seamless look. Now I'm going to set the eyelids with a loose powder, and I'm also going to apply it under my eyes before I get into the eyeshadow, because if I have any fallout, I can easily clean it up with a clean brush without budging my rest of my face. Now for the eyes, we need to make them look a little thinner, longer, elongated and more angular. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my pen eyeliner. I think the best is to work with a pen eyeliner because you want that precision in the inner corners. So I'm going to use my PAC Cosmetics Precision Stroke Eyeliner, and I'm going to start with creating a tiny V from my tear duct. Now what you have to ensure is that it's a little drooping from the inner corner so that you can give it a little angular and lifted look when it comes to the outer corners. I'm also going to fill in the gap between the tear duct and the pointed V that I've created with my liner. Now I'm going to stop right there without applying it on the centers of my eyelid, because if I apply the eyeliner on the centers of my eyelid, it'll give it a little rounded shape, which we do not want. Today I'm going to use the Tartlet palette in Bloom from Tarte, and I'm going to use this shade in Sparkly Pants right here just to set my eyes. Now I'm going to take the deepest shade from the palette, and with my Morphe B16 brush, I'm going to create a smoked out wing. I'm going to start with the end of my lower lash line and just extend it to make it a little longer and elongated smoky liner. If you notice, I'm not going to go too much inside on the center of my lids. I'm just going to stop right there and create the smoked out look. Now taking the PAC Cosmetics 381 brush and taking the shade Leader, I'm going to smoke it out and give that blended look. Now I'm going to curl my lashes and apply lots of mascara before I jump into my false lashes. Now I'm not going to apply too much in the inner side because that's not what we want. We want to emphasize on the outer side of the eyes. So I'm going to apply more on the center and the outer side. Now for the lashes, what we need to do is we need to apply from the center of the lids and not from the inner corners, because otherwise it'll look like a regular eye. But today we're doing foxy eyes, so we need to start from the center of the lid. So I've cut my lash into two and I'm going to use the back side of it. Now when I'm applying my lash, I'm going to place it on my natural lash line from the centers of my lid. But when I'm going towards the back, I'm going to just lift it a little bit over my natural lash line, so it gives a lifted and angular look. I'm also going to smoke out my lower lash line because I just feel I need to. And without taking any more eyeshadow from the palette, I'm using the same Morphe brush that I used to take the deepest shade from the palette. I'm just going to smoke out my lower lash line. So this is it, guys. This is my version of the foxy eye look. I hope you guys liked it. If you did, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. If you end up recreating this look, please don't forget to tag me as well. For those who are new here, I post videos every week and I will see you very soon in my next video. Thank you for watching.